indeed. Etta, do you have a smudge of something under your nose?
This is no smudge. I'm growing a mustache.
A mustache tattoo, really?
Yes, you know, all the great romantic figures, they all had mustache. Clark Gable, Casanova, Burt Reynolds. Is something wrong, boss?
Oh, no. I was just thinking of the poor ladies. They won't have a chance now, will they?
I'm a real devil, right, boss?
They're worse, tattoo. The absolute worst. Does the name Jack Kincaid mean anything to you?
The racing car driver?
To refer to Jack Kincaid as a racing car driver is like referring to Michelangelo as a house painter.
So, that's why we were so busy the last couple of weeks. I was in Monte Carlo the year he won the Grand Prix.
Oh.
Is that him?
It is indeed, Tattoo. And his wife, Rachel, and son, Patrick, who think they've come here just for a vacation.
But there is something else?
There is something else, Tattoo. That limp Mr. Kincaid walks with was caused by a terrible crash. A crash that ended his racing career and haunts him. A crash he's asked us to recreate. Miss Renee Lansing, 26, single, all the way from New York City.
A very pretty lady, and single too. What's her fantasy, boss?
In part, just to spend her vacation with us.
Vacation? At these prices, there must be a dozen places where she can go for half price.
Yes, but those other places cannot guarantee she won't be recognized.
Why don't she want to be recognized?
Because for just a little while in her life, she wants to be Renee Lansing, just another young woman from New York City, instead of who she really is. Belinda Green, a very expensive lady of the evening.
You mean she's a...
I mean she is our guest. My dear guests, I am Mr. Rock, your host. Welcome to Fantasy Island.
Say that. Unless, of course, you're used to getting hit from the blind side. Inspector Clouseau, at your service.
Oh, thanks.
Tell me what was in this. I'll stumble back over to the bar and get you a refill.
No, that's not necessary.
Well, maybe not for you, but I have a reputation to maintain. See, I figure if I'm lucky, I can wipe out about four or five more people before I get back to the bar. You wouldn't want to stop me from maintaining my quota, would you?
I'm afraid I'm going to have to, Mr.
Fredericks, Bill. And you're?
Late, Mr. Fredericks. Now, if you'll just excuse me.
Boss.
Tattoo, I've beaten you 183 straight races.
But, boss, you promised to race me again if I practiced.
Lack of persistency is certainly not one of your failings, is it? Are you ready? Oh,
Too bad, too. Ah, Mr. Kincaid, I thought you and your family had gone horseback riding for the afternoon.
Well, I sort of begged off. I told him I'd catch up to him later.
Oh, I see.
Tell you the truth, I've been kind of anxious to start on my fantasy.
Well, Mr. Kincaid, we'll be happy to show you what we've completed of your fantasy so far, but it will still be a couple of days before everything is ready. It takes time to construct a replica of the Kincaid special.
You're not telling me you've rebuilt the Kincaid special.
Oh, but we have indeed.
But all I asked for was a car and a track to race on.
Oh, I know what you asked for, Mr. Kincaid. But wasn't your real fantasy to recreate as much as possible the conditions that existed a year ago when you raced and crashed?
Thank you. I'll take it.
Oh, thanks. Could you start a tab, please?
Don't press your luck. I could spill the next one down your back. May I?
Well,
Oh, you're expecting someone.
Yes.
Don't tell me. Let me guess. He's the president of Harvard. And he's come here to Fantasy Island to give you a job as a professor of American literature, specializing in Ralph Waldo.
I beg your pardon.
Ralph Waldo Emerson. The book? The book you were reading. The one I gave a bath to? You know, I got thinking about that later on. And I decided that the only people that read Emerson anymore are college professors, literature freaks, and high school teachers like me.
Well, I'm sorry, but it's none of the above. I just happen to like his poetry, that's all.
So do I. But trying to sell him to a bunch of high school kids that think Fonzie is a poet laureate. Well, now that's a different story.
My girlfriend has the same problem. Only she starts them off with comic books.
If she ever runs out, send her to me. I've got Spider-Man back to 73. And some very difficult to get copies of The Incredible Hulk.
Now, listen, if I were you, I'd keep that very quiet. I'm expecting my friends in a few minutes.
Well, there's no problem. I have lots of things to catch up on myself. It's been lovely talking to you, whoever you are.
I'm sorry. Renee Lansing. And thanks for the drink.
My pleasure. Well, I hope I see you later on, Renee Lansing. And remember, if ever you need Spider-Man, I'm available.
Almost exactly like the San Carlos track. Right down to...
To the north embankment, Mr. Kincaid. The north embankment, where at 160 miles an hour, your car ran off the track, through a barrier, and burst into flames.
We're just about ready to get on the way. Here comes the starting out, and there is the green flag. Here is Kincaid, wide open! Kincaid is through the fence! Let us down, Kincaid, through the fence!
You're a man who does his homework, Mr. Rourke.
I must be anxious to see your car.
Corky?
Yeah.
Jack! Jack, it's really you!
Hey, man!
You monkey, how'd they get you out here?
Well, who else could put this machine together besides me?
Well, it's you. You're as ugly as ever.
What, you ain't exactly Cheryl Ladd, baby.
Thanks a lot, pal.
God, it's good to see you.
You know, last time I saw you was back at that hospital. And they were saying that you'd never walk again.
Yeah, it's coming along pretty good.
Hold on a minute. Mr. Rourke?
Hello, Corky.
Mr. Rourke, would it be all right if I stayed here? I'd like to look over the car a bit.
Oh, by all means, Mr. Kincaid. I'll send a jeep for you in an hour. There'll still be time to meet your family.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So long, Corky.
Rachel here?
Yeah, she's out with a boy. They're looking over the island on horseback.
She know you're here to drive?
Oh, there's no point in telling her. She wouldn't have gone along with it anyway.
Maybe she's right this time, Jack.
We go to get up next to him. Here is Kincaid. Look at, he's opening up now. 130, 140 miles an hour. Kincaid, 160 miles an hour. Wide open. And wait, Kincaid is out of control. Kincaid is out
of
control.
Jack. Jack?
Hey, I'm sorry, what?
I said maybe Rachel's right this time.
What are you talking about?
The whole thing's getting kind of scary to me. The island, Mr. Rourke, same track, same automobile, the way he's gotten us all here. I think we ought to call the thing off right now.
No, it's too late for that. It's a long time too late.
Just brushing up my new camera. Other than comic books, I'm very into photography.
How long were you watching?
Just a few seconds. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to startle you.
No.
It's just that you look so beautiful sitting there. Almost like you belong here.
When I was a little girl, I used to take long walks in the country, dreaming of what my life was going to be like. My parents had a house in Vermont. I used to look forward to those summers more than anything.
Did any of those summer dreams ever come true?
No. Not many.
You know, you're a very beautiful lady, but you're also difficult to talk to.
That wasn't part of the package.
What?
It's time to leave.
Renee, I hope I didn't say anything to upset you. Okay?
I'm fine.
Sure. That's why you're shaking, I believe.
I'm just a little bit wobbly. Thank God you were here.
It's perfectly okay. All in a day's work for the Spider-Man. You realize, of course, I expect some kind of a reward.
What did you have in mind?
I don't know. Why don't we go up to the Spider-Man's web and discuss it?
Nothing ever changes, does it?
Did I say something wrong again?
No. Just predictable.
Oh, come on. I was only kidding.
Yeah. The hell you were.
Oh, forget it. A simple thank you might have been okay. But I guess for you, even that would have been a strain.
Wipe that off for you.
Wipe what?
Will you have something? Oh, my goodness. You're growing it. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know. I'm so sorry.
Patience. Rome wasn't built in a day either. Casanova told me it took him quite some time to raise a proper mustache.
Casanova told you?
Hey, I told you I'd catch up to you. And you know it'd be time to get something to eat. That is, if there's enough.
There's more than enough. Come and get it.
Dad, you should have seen it back there. There's a waterfall that's gotta be 200 feet tall.
Well, after lunch, you can take me back up there and we can take a look at it, okay? What's wrong, hon?
Your hands. They look like you've been working on a car.
Oh, that's probably because I ran in Mr. Rourke on the way out here, and he asked me to look at a Jeep that was giving him some trouble.
Oh.
And what's bothering you?
I guess for a moment I got scared. I thought of racing cars and...
Well, we gotta think about racing cars sometime. I mean, Dad is gonna race again, isn't he?
Patrick, you were there when your father announced his retirement.
Yeah, but,
But what?
Well, it was just a couple of months after he got out of the hospital, and people figured that...
Figured what?
That he really didn't mean it.
Jack, is there something I don't know about? Have you changed your mind?
Okay.
Hi.
Can I come in? I'm not carrying a bomb. Promise.
Well, in that case.
I came here to apologize. You're nice people. Too nice for the way I treated you.
Now, look.
No, don't. I was stupid. I just wish that there was something that I could do about it.
Actually, there is something you can do.
There is?
You can take me to dinner tonight.
I can, eh?
And you'd better have lots of money with you, because I'm starved.
Mr. Rourke, I was hoping to see you. I did it. I mean, I really did it. I beat Jimmy Connors 3 straight sets.
Oh, Mr. Brennan, I'm so happy for you. You must have been magnificent.
Magnificent? I was terrific. Of course, Jimbo hit some good shots, but once we got to the old tiebreaker, the kid folded. You have something on your lip.
Thank you.
I can't believe it. I mean, I just cannot believe it.
Well, perhaps you should find your wife, Mr. Brennan. She must be anxious to know the outcome.
My wife? My wife, I forgot all about her. See you later.
Tell me the truth, boss. Was that player he beat really Jimmy Connors?
Tatu, will I ever deceive a guest?
Does duck make quack quack in the water?
Oh, I can't remember an evening when I've laughed so much. Thank you.
Don't thank me. You picked up the tab, remember?
That's not what I meant.
Listen. What are your plans for tomorrow?
I don't know. I guess I don't have any.
What do you do now? I'll pick you up here at 9 sharp.
Do you have anything specific in mind? I mean, it would help to know what to wear.
I tell you what. I'll call you at 8. You think about it overnight, and we can make a decision then.
Fine.
Okay.
Best I've been in years. I'll talk to you at 8. Hello?
Hello. Belinda? Is that you?
It's Roy Berg. I saw you over in the restaurant.
I'm sorry, but you've got the wrong number.
Belinda, you must remember me. The hotel in New York. The desk clerk called you.
Look, there is no Belinda here.
Oh. Well, you can't kill a guy for making an honest mistake. Listen, whoever you are, what are you doing tonight?
I'm going to bed. Good night.
A month, Dad.
Yeah, well, it looks like your old man's got a boogeyman running around in his head. Well, after we chase him out, I guess we never know when he'll pop up. I appreciate the concern. Now I think we should all go back to sleep.
Night, Dad.
Good night, son. He's a good kid.
The shame of it is that he thinks you're the greatest man that ever lived.
Hey, a kid should think his old man is great. What's wrong with that?
Maybe nothing. Until you end up killing him.
What are you talking about?
The grease under your nails. Now, for the first time in months, one of your nightmares. I wasn't wrong this afternoon, was I? You've already made up your mind. We came to this island so you could race, didn't we?
Yeah. I guess we did. Look, honey. Rachel, it's not the way you think.
Isn't it? Then why didn't you tell me? Why did you lie to me?
I didn't tell you because I didn't want you to worry about it. It's not even a real race. It's an empty track and just my car.
That's what it is now. But before long, you'll be back on the circuit again, won't you? And then Patrick will want to work with you again. Before long, he'll be a driver, too. And I can sit in the stands and wonder which one dies today.
Hey, whoa, back up. Patrick is just a kid. We don't know if he's going to go into racing. He's got a whole life ahead of him.
Not as long as you're still driving, he doesn't.
What's that supposed to mean?
Jack, it's not your fault. Don't you see that Patrick's life is ruled by the fact that he's your son? That's his identity to his classmates, to the world. And if you go back to racing now, that's all he'll ever be.
That's not fair to lay that on me. That boy'll grow.
Fair? I sat in a hospital for almost a month with you more dead than alive. I didn't know from one hour to the next if I was a widow or not.
Rachel, don't you understand? I can't walk away from this.
Why? Why can't we walk away from racing? It can't be the money. We have enough money for 10 lifetimes.
Damn it, Rachel, you know it's not the money. It has to do with what a man has inside himself. Or what he doesn't. Ever since that crash, I've lived a nightmare. I gotta find out what's still left inside me.
That makes us even. Now I guess I'll have to stop playing around.
Playing around? I thought I was going to need to call a respirator.
Belinda? Belinda, it is you.
Sorry. It's Renee. Renee Lansing.
Renee? Oh. Well, if you say so. Maybe I got the name mixed up, but don't you remember me?
Sorry.
Burke. Roy Burke. What's the name of that hotel? You remember.
Of course. The convention. My group presented a fashion show, and you were the one that took us all out to dinner afterwards. That's it.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Now you got it.
Yeah.
We just about turned that big apple upside down, didn't we?
Yes.
Well, Renee, nice seeing you.
Bye.
Hope we bump into each other again real soon.
Bye.
Bye.
Sometimes it's a great disadvantage to be a model.
Well, we all have to compromise somewhere along the line.
Bill, do you mind if I cop out on this last set? I think the heat's getting to me.
Sure. As long as you promise me a rematch.
Yeah. No. I'm fine. Call me this afternoon, okay? Bye.
Bye.
Well, boss, what do you think? It's really me, isn't it?
Well, it's really something. But this afternoon, it was just a little stubble.
Oh, I fill it in with a little shoe polish.
You painted it on?
Well, it was either that or not going to the discotheque tonight. It's only until it grows out by itself.
Oh, of course. Of course.
Come in, please.
Ah, Miss Lansing. What can I do for you?
Well, for openers, I'd like to have my money back.
Oh, something wrong?
And I suppose you're going to tell me that you had nothing to do with a man called Roy Burke being here?
On the contrary, Miss Lansing, I did, most assuredly.
But that's not fair. My fantasy was to spend my vacation in a place where nobody would recognize me.
Was it? Really?
What do you mean?
Oh, my dear Miss Lansing, wasn't your real fantasy to see if you could change your lifestyle? Change it despite the temptations a wealthy man like Roy Burke could provide. Change it enough so you could really be the type of woman, a good, decent man like, we'll say Bill Fredericks, could care for.
You're very certain of yourself, aren't you? Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, Mr. Rourke, but my participation in this little puppet show is over. You can play with somebody else's life. I want to leave on the next plane.
That would be tomorrow afternoon. I'll arrange it.
the incredible American driver, Jack Kincaid. And look at this, already he's moving out in front. Running second at this point, Alfredo Martinez, the Mexican road race star. And running in third in the Lotus is Marshall Klein. Here is Kincaid, look at, he's opening up now. 130, 140 miles an hour. Kincaid, 160 miles an hour, wide open. And wait, Kincaid is out of control. Kincaid is through the fence. Ladies and gentlemen, Kincaid through the fence. Kincaid is through the fence. Ladies and gentlemen, Kincaid through the fence.
Leave me alone, please.
Would you prefer that I spoke with your boyfriend? I thought that might do it.
What do you want?
What do I want? Well, I'll settle for what I got last time. The way I figure it, after today, you owe me.
Get out!
Come on, honey. I'll pay. This isn't a freebie.
You don't understand. For the first time in my life, I found someone. Someone special.
Oh. Someone special, huh? Don't tell me you think you're in love with that school teacher. Honey, come on. You and him? How long do you think that could last? I mean, you're not exactly the type for a little white house with a picket fence.
Can you be so sure?
Yeah, I can be sure. I bought and paid for you once, remember? Fast cars, pretty diamonds, Sam Moritz. That's your style, baby. And it's a good one, too. And it's guys like me that pay for it. Listen. You want to play games? That's fine. You go have your fun with your school teacher. He doesn't have to know anything about us. As long as we can have our fun together, too.
Okay. Bill and I have a dinner date. Meet me here afterwards.
You got it. I'll be back at 10. It'll be like old times.
Nice place.
Very. I feel like we're back in the tennis courts. But instead of a net between us, it's more like a wall.
I'm sorry.
Renee, what's wrong? Talk to me.
I don't know. I guess I'm just realizing that all this is going to be over soon.
But it doesn't have to be. As a matter of fact, I've been thinking lately. I have a couple of weeks before the new term starts. How would you feel about me coming to New York for a few days?
Why?
Why? Oh, I don't know, to see the Empire State Building, feed the pigeons in Central Park, to get to know the lady I think I'm falling in love with.
What did you say?
I said, I think I'm falling in love with you. Please, don't run away.
This is not going to work between us, Bill. It's not.
Renee. What's the matter? Isn't that the man we met on the tennis courts? Renee. I don't know what's going on. You have to talk to me.
There is nothing to talk about. Nothing. I'm sorry.
Our future.
As much as I wish there was, we have no future. As long as there's men like him. In fact, he's due in my room at 10 o'clock. Some sort of payoff. So he won't tell you the truth about what I really am. The truth is, Bill, I'm a hooker.
Good evening, Belinda. Excuse me, Renee.
I see you're still trying for the little white house with a picket fence, huh?
Only this time she's going to make it, if I have anything to say about it.
Well, maybe you and I ought to have a little talk, friend.
There's nothing you can tell me. Nothing that I haven't known all along. If I were you, friend, I'd take that smiling face of yours out of public before somebody like me flattens it.
How did you find out?
I've known about it all along.
But how?
4 years ago, I went to New York. I met Belinda Green.
Then you were one of my...
customers? I guess so. I was alone, scared, out of my element. I was very lonely. You came over. And I've been in love with you ever since.
But if you knew about what I am, why didn't you say something?
Because I was afraid we wouldn't have the chance to get to know one another, that you'd run away, that I wouldn't be able to say all the things I wanted to say.
About coming to New York?
No. About loving you. About how alone I was that night. And how vulnerable you were. I've never stopped thinking about you.
When you came here, what was your fantasy?
Don't you know? My fantasy was finding you. And Mr. Rourke promised I would.
Then that's what he wanted all along.
I love you very much.
Please. Don't ever stop. Don't ever stop.
He's conquered his past, Tattoo. Now all that remains is his future. Mrs. Kincaid, Patrick, you seem to be just in time.
Well, he's not supposed to drive till 10, and it's not even 7 yet.
Maybe he was anxious.
I didn't expect you down here.
I don't know what the big surprise is.
After what you said the other night.
That's in the past. I don't want to lose you. At least not because I took you away from this.
Well, Dad, when do we get started?
We don't, Patrick.
What do you mean?
I came out early this morning to walk the track. Think about it. And that's what I did. I'm not going to race anymore, son.
I don't get it.
Well, let me explain.
Explain?
Well, at least let me talk to you.
What's to talk about? You lost your nerve.
Patrick! He'll be back. He'll be back a man.
See, things seem to be working out for you.
Things are working out just fine.
Better than fine.
Well, since your fantasy was, in a sense, reality, at least you have a good head start. Good luck.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye. And I'm sorry, Miss Lansing, if I ever hurt such a lovely lady.
Thank you for everything.
Not at all, Mrs. Kincaid. Pleasant journeys, Mr. Kincaid.
Same to you, Mr. Rourke.
There is a saying that might serve you well in life, young Mr. Kincaid. Cowards die many times before their death. The valiant never taste death but once. Perhaps someday you'll realize what a brave man your father really is.
Let's go, son. Time to go.
Thank you.
Tattoo, I've just realized. Your mustache, it's gone.
I decided it was not for me.
But you said all the romantic figures through history had mustaches. Casanova, Clark Gable, Burt Reynolds. Wasn't it working for you?
It was working right until the time I was whispering sweet nothings until Suzanne hears.
You don't mean...
shoe polish all over her face?
Nobody's perfect, boss.
Indeed.